Rap songs often go through several different iterations before they're released, most of which we'll never get to hear. Sometimes a song originally had different features, a different beat, sometimes it had different verses. There's so many things that can change before we get that final version that's publicly distributed. And sometimes these original versions of released tracks are found, and in some cases, they're even better than what we got on the release version. So I wanted to share some of my favorite examples of this with you. Before we start, I want to give a big thank you to a viewer of mine, The Archive, for helping me discover most of the songs that I'm going to be talking about here today, and for providing info about the backstory of a lot of them. So with that being said, let's get started with our first one. Smoke some, drink some, pop one. Smoke some, drink some, pop one. It tastes good like soul food. Parked up outside in the old school. This was the first one that came into my head while making this video. It's probably the earliest example I can think of where I came across an unreleased version for an already existing track. I still really like SDP how it is on Birds in the Trap. I think it works as a nice hazy atmospheric interlude, and I do like how the Cassie vocals are used on it. But I just love how Travis glides on the verses of the unreleased SDP, especially on the first one. Got your hand on my Glock while your ass ride shotgun. I'll say this about a few of these probably, but this is one that I think would be ideal if you combined a little bit of something from both versions. Like for example, if just the first verse from this unreleased version of SDP was placed on the album version, I think that would improve it personally. I do like both, but I'm including it here because the unreleased one is the one I'm listening to more often right now. I do get a little bit more enjoyment out of it at the moment. This is one of those good examples where I like both versions of the song. The same cannot be said for the next one on this list. I gotta get to the cat, I gotta get to the breach, send a nigga up to heaven, preach, and I smoke that grade A. What in the ever-loving fuck did Pop Smoke's label head Steven Victor do to this track? Are you out of your mind? Top Shot has started during the Meet the Woo 1 sessions is everything that you love to hear from Pop Smoke, with a dark, steady production that blended perfectly with his more raspy delivery. And it had a feature from fellow New Yorker Eli Frost. Sounds pretty good, but it never came out officially. So naturally, when it came time to release Pop Smoke's posthumous Faith album in 2021, the decision was made by Pop Smoke's label to finally release Top Shotta on an album of Pop Smoke's. But for some inexplicable reason, they changed that production to this terrible, upbeat, tropical production and completely changed the feature list. How do you butcher this song this badly? The beat did have to be changed because the original one had a sample on it that Pop Smoke's label didn't want to clear, but why couldn't it have been changed to something that at least had a similar vibe to the original production? This is an abomination. Out of everything in this video, this one is the biggest fumble. The original Top Shotta is good. The album version is absolutely embarrassing and a complete waste of a Pusha T feature. It really shows how little consideration for Pop Smoke's style and sound was actually put into the Faith album. Drop this shit and had these pussies dropping like some motherfucking type of nigga that can't look me in the eyes. I despise. Let them bullets fly, sang his ass a lullaby. We'll rock about it, baby, hit him. I remember when I first heard Knife Talk, I thought that it pretty much just sounded like Drake tried to make a 21 Savage song and then got him to feature on it. Turns out that that's because it did start as a 21 song, and if you ask me, his version is better. Gang Shit by 21 was originally intended to be for Savage Mode 2, which I think is pretty clear just from the sound of it, but it was swapped for Mr. Right Now in a trade with Drake that doesn't really make sense to me. Mr. Right Now would fit on CLB better, and Gang Shit, which would go on to become Knife Talk, would fit on Savage Mode 2 better. I don't know if they intentionally swapped the vibes to be cute or something. Drake was probably like,
it would make sense to have this song on Savage Mode 2, and it would make sense to have my song on CLB, but what if we switched them? Wouldn't that be crazy?
But regardless, the song is more enjoyable for me without Drake cosplaying as a murderer, talking about how it's getting real oppy outside, just carnying up the joint. Also, as a little bonus, the Project Pat intro is longer and clearer than on Knife Talk. Once you hear 21's original, Drake's version sounds even more forced and awkward. Gang Shit is undeniably better to me.
Rich nigga, broke phone, trying to keep the balance, I'm staying strong. Stop playing with me before I turn you to a song. Stop playing with me before I turn you to a song. Bitch, I'm attractive, handsome ass, ugly nigga, attractive.
I feel like this might be the most disagreed with pick in this video. I'm not sure, but man, Bitchface is such a fun version of what would go on to become Rich Spirit. Don't get me wrong, Rich Spirit fits way more on Mr. Morale with the more personal feel to it, whereas Bitchface feels more like something that Kendrick made while he was in his goofing around with Baby Keem era, but I really like it. If we're talking about which version I have a better time listening to, it's Bitchface. That beat is just so fun and bouncy and fits this more goofy delivery of the hook really nicely. All the verses are so smooth too.
Live good like a king, but you can't sit with me. Holding big protein, but you can't sit with me. Hopping in the back, but you can't sit with me.
Again, I'm not saying that it's more meaningful or that it should take Rich Spirit's place on Mr. Morale. It's just the version of the song that I listen to more. Rich Spirit is okay to me. Bitchface is very fun. Now, the next four picks I have for this video are all from one artist because they have so many unreleased versions of their songs floating around out there. You might have guessed who it is already just from that, so without further ado, let's get into the Kanye West section of this video.
It's been plenty time you close the door on me. That really show me how much you say you a bro to me. They gon' give me perks and when I take it, I get spiritual. My angels and my demons.
I did think it was a bit strange to have 5EO's ad-libs on the release version of this track on Donda without him actually having a verse on the song. The original version of OK OK proves that he actually did have a verse on it at first, and it was really good. I don't know why they cut it. 5EO seemed to go extra hard for the Donda sessions because I feel like I just haven't really heard him rap as well since. It's no off the grid, but he's still intense and fired up. I like Yachty's verse on both versions. His one on the unreleased song is completely different, but it still hits.
All my niggas call my mama, mama, we on family time. I end up on a cereal box from all this mumble rhyming.
And I'm fine with Ruga not being on it because he was my least favorite part of the released version. The only flaw of the original OK OK, in my opinion, is that the mixing isn't as clean, but that's because it's an early version of the song. It would have been cleaned up if it was going to come out. The actual song itself, though, is really solid.
Jesus is Lord. Every knee shall bow.
Come on.
We know, yeah. God's trumpet sound.
Someday.
This one was such an easy pick for me. Jesus is Lord is one of the most forgettable songs on Jesus is King, not what you really want with an outro, with a runtime of less than a minute, and it not doing very much with that runtime. All of that is rectified by two early versions of the song known as Baptized and Every Knee Shall Bow. Baptized has those Pierre Bourne drums, which adds so much to the song. The instrumental slaps. It's just a shame that version is basically an instrumental without a verse from Kanye. Which is why I've also picked that second selection here, Every Knee Shall Bow. It's just flat out beautiful. It doesn't have the Pierre drums, but it does add vocals from the Sunday Service Choir and Kirk Franklin, making for a much more complete sounding track. And the small extra things added to the production are so nice.
Jesus.
This should have been the Jesus is King outro. It's so much better. I'm baffled as to why the choir wasn't left in at the very least. It adds so much to the song.
Got us clean out of soda. Before the flood, people judge. They did the same thing to Noah.
Global warming getting closer. Thank God I'm bipolar. Whole life on a floater.
Chakras is essentially the Yandi version of what would go on to become Selah on Jesus is King.
And man, do I wish we got Yandi so badly.
It also just makes me think about the wasteland of potential that Jesus is King is. This is the second song on this list that was made worse before being put on that album. Selah is definitely one of the least bad Jesus is King songs, but I still find it pretty forgettable and sanitized. Chakras, on the other hand, that makes you feel something as soon as it starts. Those piano keys are slick as hell.
Yeah, this is one and only. Can't tell a unicorn from a pony. Live freedom, this is freedom. Fuck your feelings, you can keep them.
Also, just throwing this out there, but a Young Thug or Migos feature on this version of Chakras would have absolutely slapped. I even like the really intense second verse and outro from Kanye. Some people don't love it that much, but it gets me energized.
We like the woo, y'all niggas who puffin' the woo, woo.
Just another piece of evidence right here that we probably lost something great with Yandi never releasing.
Well, no one ain't around.
I feel it fade.
Now hear me out here. This one might be kinda cheating a little bit because I selected the original version of Fade due to its potential. It definitely needed a lot of work and was not finished, but if it got polished up to an album release standard, I think Fade over this version of the instrumental would be so cool. Listen to how interesting this sounds compared to the more simplified version that we got on Life of Pablo. Maybe you prefer the slightly stripped down album version, and I do like Post Malone on that version of the song, but something about the original production just feels so interesting to me. It's got this more psychedelic edge to it that really adds some vibrance to the track. Fade from Pablo is still nice, but the original version is very interesting to me, and I can't get over that beat.
Every month, I'm supposed to pay her bills and get her what she want. I still got like 7 years of doing what I want. My dad still got child support from 1991.
Pretty simple to explain this one. The beat for the unreleased I'm Upset helps to make the track feel not entirely devoid of life. Now, even this leaked one does have the trademark Scorpion blandness to it, and I still don't think it's particularly great. Not much from this era of Drake is for me, but I still think it clears what we did get on the album. Drake just typically sounds better over more soulful production rather than dark, eerie production. I'm Upset as it is on Scorpion is just empty as hell, even with the slightly more energetic delivery from Drake on it.
It's short and I'm a daughter with no semi on me. If we got a problem, we get rid of homie. Put 20,000 in your pocket, we gon' get the money.
Sip it out of wine glass, this ain't none no Remy.
And for our last one, we have a track that took me a while to decide whether I was gonna actually include it or not. I really like the release version of Bandit with NBA YoungBoy, mainly for Juice WRLD, but I do have a lot of nostalgia attached to that track. However, after hearing the original Juice WRLD solo version of it, I don't know if I can go back. He has a really enjoyable second verse on this one. The flows are different enough to verse one for them to stand out. It's not like the second verse was cut out because it was just more of the same. I think it adds to the song.
Like a version of something that you can't fuck with me. My 40 Velcro is something cause it stuck with me. You run up on me, kill, take.
It's close, but I think I like Juice's second verse a little bit more than what NBA YoungBoy did on the song, even though I do think YoungBoy is still good on it. This is another example of a track where I like both versions, and I'm definitely not unhappy with what we ended up getting at the end. I just think that the unreleased version has a slight edge over the final one. Now, there are many, many more songs that I could have included in a video like this, but that would probably make it like an hour long, and I always like leaving lists open for a potential part two in the future. Then again, I'm sure some of you would probably like to hear me talking about unreleased versions of songs for an hour or more, but we're not doing that today, okay? It's been a while since I've uploaded one of my usual videos like this. I've just been focused on moving out here to Canada, and I'm finally here now for the next 2 years at least, so that's pretty cool, and I just wanted to get this one out there for you guys. With that being said, let me know your favorite original versions of released songs down in the comments below, especially if they weren't included in this video, and you can click on the screen right there to check out my reaction to Eminem's most recent album, The Death of Slim Shady. Thank you for watching, and much love to my channel members and Patreon supporters over there, with a special shout out to I Am Regent, KWG13270, Lucas11123, Nail Striker, and Worms.